Hello, everyone. We are beginning this subject, airport planning and designing. And we will begin with the first lecture, air transportation and its development. I am Sandeep Panchal with you, and we will begin with some historical facts of air transportation according to the world's perspective and according to India's perspective. So here are the contents. So we will talk about air transportation, its introduction. Then we will talk about different characteristics of the air transportation. Then advantages and limitations of the air transportation. After that, we will compare air transportation with land, water, and even with railways. Then we will talk about history of air transportation according to world's perspective. After that, we will talk about development of air transportation in India. And at the end, we will talk about some agencies at international level and national level which deal with air transportation. So let's begin with air transportation and introduction. So airways or airway is the route or corridor that connects the two locations along which an aircraft flies. In the transportation engineering, there are two components. One is the vehicle and another one is the way or the corridor. So in highway, the pavement is the way and the vehicle can be the trucks, buses, etc. In railway, the rails can be the way and the vehicle is of course the wagons or the trains. In airway, the air, the space is the way and the vehicle is the aircraft or aeroplane. So air transportation is the fastest mode of transportation. It is the most modern kind of transportation. And it has reduced the travel time significantly. So it is known for its innovation and the modern concept in transportation engineering. So these are the characteristics of air transportation. That continuous journey. Air transportation facilitates the continuous journey that there are no breaks despite of the conditions of topography. It may be a sea or it may be plain area or it may be a hilly region. You don't require any break in the journey. You can overcome all the obstructions. Rapidity, it is the fastest mode of transportation. So within less time, it can take you to the destination. Costly, from economics point of view, air transport is very costly. Next one is the comfort of passengers. It is more comfortable as compared to all other modes of transportation. Accessibility, you can reach anywhere by using air transport where their highways or railways can't reach. At such inaccessible places, you can reach by air transport. Time saving, as we said that rapidity is a characteristic of air transport. So it is time saving also. Special preparedness, that for air transportation, you will require some special provisions. So you, special preparedness is required. Safety, statistics says that air transport is safest as compared to the other in case of accidents. But whenever an accident takes place, then it is highly risky. Air transport has an international character that it don't care about the boundaries and it connects the countries within the world. So here are the advantages of the air transportation. High speed or time saving is the first advantage. Due to its rapidity, it saves a lot of time. Easy transport. For the less weight goods, it is easy transport. They are easy to transport goods with less weight, but it is not that good for the heavy goods. Comfortable services. Air transportation provide comfortable services to its customers. In case of air transportation, there are no physical barriers or boundaries. It can go to the typical places like the places which are inaccessible. whenever we say a transportation mode, then there is always an investment on the track or the way. Like in highways, there is an investment on the pavement. In railway, there is an investment on the rails. But in air transportation, there is no investment on track. There is a defense or strategic advantage of the air transportation, as it can be used for the military purposes. It can also be used in emergency services, like airlifting of the people who are stuck in other countries, or it can be used in the disasters like floods, etc. These are the limitations of air transportation. The operation cost and maintenance cost is highest as compared to the other mode of transportation. Air transportation can carry less weight. It is not useful for the heavy loads. There is a risk of breakdowns or accidents. In case of breakdown or accidents, there will be great loss of life. For air transportation, specialized skills are required. It is unsafe in case of accidents. It is risky, highly risky. It is controlled by climatic conditions, that if the climatic conditions are not favorable, then the flights can get delayed. There are legal restrictions internationally that some of the countries may not give you permission to enter in their territory due to their peace issues or due to their legal issues. So here are the comparison with the other modes of transportation. We are comparing it with respect to highways, waterways, railways, and the characteristics are given like that. In case of speed, airways have very high speed, while railways and highways have moderate speed, and waterways are the slowest one. In case of operation cost, airways have maximum cost. Highways have the cost more than waterways and railways. And in case of waterways have the least cost, operation cost, low transfer capacity, least is for airways. Airways can transfer least load, while railways can transfer maximum loads. Waterways can also transport a significant load. Frequency. For highways, the frequency is high. For waterways, very low. Railways, low. And for airways, it is average. Availability. Highways are very highly available. Waterways are very low available. The availability of the railways is average, and of airways is low. Flexibility. Highways are averagely flexible, while airways are low flexible, have low flexibility. Railways are highly flexible, and waterways are very high flexibility. Investment on the way, that in airways and waterways, there is no investment on the way or the corridor, while in railways and highways, the investments are high. So here is the history of air transportation from the world's perspective. So I have attached a research paper in the references. You can go through it. So it has divided the history of air transportation in three parts. The first part is the dream flying. The dream flying that every culture has assumed some power of flying or some god's power of flying. Even in Indian literature, Ramayana has the concept of Pushpak Viman. So such things were dream flying that were written in the literature, and we don't have any physical model about these flying. After that, there are the physical models that are given, first of all, given by Leonardo da Vinci, who made some drawings of the flying machine. He considered that the larger the size of the wing, and we will be able to overcome the resistance of the air, and in this way, the human can fly. In 1783, Montgo Flyer brothers first time invented the hot air balloon. Sir George Cayley postulated principles of flying in his paper, that it was a scientific paper that defines that in this way the human will achieve the flying. In the beginning of 19th century, it is attempted that we can fly an aircraft with the help of steam engine, which was an unsuccessful attempt. So Montgo Flyer brothers were successful in flying a hot air balloon, but the problem was that hot air balloon was not controllable. We could not control the air balloon, so we can't give the directions. So Hermann Helmholtz in 1873 explained the fact that up to 1873, whatever the works have done in the case of flying can't get success. In 1831, Zeppelin developed the airship and crossed Atlantic with 50 passengers. And after that, the era of airships began, and it is assumed that the airships can be used for the strategic and strategic purposes. But after the disaster of Zeppelin ZL-129 airship, the concept of airship transportation got ended immediately. In 1890, Clement Eder made a steam-powered flying machine, but it flew only up to a distance of 50 meters, which was very less. In 1890, Otto developed his first gliding vehicle, and here came the concept of gliders. On December 17th, 1903, Wright Brothers presents world's first airplane, which was heavier than air and well-controlled and powered. From 1831, we have clearly assumed that the machines, which are based on the principle that the weight of the machine should be less than the air, they will not work. And after that, a significant progress took place. From 1850 to 1900, there were a lot of models of airships and the planes were proposed, but none of them was a success in real means. So in 1909, Louis Blériot invented an airplane, and with this airplane, he crossed the English Channel, which was quite impressive. It is said that during World War I, 80,000 flying machines were constructed and used. In 1909, regular air transport was started by Delague. In 1920, first male flight, and a year later, first night flight began. And we consider that there were improvements in the engines and the propulsion system of the aircrafts. And in 1960, the jet age began. So this was the historical development of air transportation in the world. So there were three kind of models there. The first model was the dream flying. Second model was the physical models, which were on the papers. And the third model was the technical model. And as we have seen that in 1903, Wright Brothers presented the first world's airplane. And in 1909, irregular air transport was started. So it took only 6 years to start the services of air transport. Let's see the same perspective, development of air transportation in India. In 1911, while in world it was 1909, in 1911, air transportation is launched for mailing services from Allahabad to Naini. British, Dutch, and French introduced their air transport in 1929 to 30. Indian National Airways was formed in 1933. And it introduced the air services between Karachi and Lahore. In 1945, most of the major cities like Delhi, Mumbai, etc. are connected by air transport. By the end of Second World War, the major cities of India were connected by air transport. And after the independence in 1953, the air transportation is nationalized. Beg your pardon. So now we come on the international agencies in air transportation. We will discuss these agencies in two parts. First of all, international agencies, and second one, are the national agencies. International agencies in air transportation, the first agency is International Civil Aviation Organization, ICAO. ICAO defines and redefines the principle of international air navigation, normally works in the planning and development of air transport. It has a concern about the growth and safety of the air transportation. After that, Federal Aviation Administration, it regulates and develops civil aeronautics. Its primary function is the research and development of air system. It also deals in noise management, traffic control devices, aircraft systems, etc. And it also deals in the safety of the air transportation. International Air Transportation Association, IATA, it represents and leads the airline industries. It regulates the airlines on the operation in foreign countries. It regulates air traffic and accounting. It also settles the disputes among the airlines. Airport Council of International, ACI. ACI is the representative of global trade of the world's airport. So it puts the interest of airport in front of the governments. It also makes a coordination with ICAO and the other agencies of air transportation, and it develops policies, standards, and gives recommendation regarding the airports. There are other international organizations that deals in safety or that deals in research and defense. These organizations may be like Air Transport Association, Flight Safety Foundation, Experimental Aircraft Association, etc. So there are a number of international agencies that are involved in air transportation research, development, or regulations, safety, etc. So here are the national agencies in air transportation. Air transportation in India is dealt under Directorate General of Civil Aviation, DGCA. So DGCA is the primary regulatory body of civil aviation in India. It deals with safety of air transportation, and it also regulates and enforces the air regulations. DGCA coordinates with International Civil Aviation Organization too. Bureau of second agency is Bureau of Civil Aviation Security, which deals with airline security, and it standardizes the airline security guidelines. Next is Airport Authority of India. Airport Authority of India deals with the modernization, development, and expansion of operational terminals and cargo facilities. The airports are designed under Airport Authority of India, and the design parameters and the standardization of the designing processes of airports comes under the Airport Authority of India. Air India Limited. Air India Limited is an airlines that is under government's control. There are many subsidiaries of Air India Limited, like Air India Charter Limited, Wildwood Limited, etc. There are another agency, Pawan Hans Helicopters Limited. It provides services for oil and gas industries. It also provides services in inaccessible and remote areas. It is also used at the time of disasters. The last organization is Rajiv Gandhi National Aviation University, that for training the pilots, this university is formed. It is a combination of university and flying training organization. There may be many other national agencies that are dealing in the air transportation. So that's it for now. This was our first lecture on air transportation. Here are the references that I have gone through. The first reference is about the historical development of air transport, which is a very interesting chapter. And then there are the links of the different agencies of international and national stature, which deals in air transportation. So thank you for your attention. Let's meet in the next lecture.